Mother Nature having her way with the First Coast yet again. For the second straight night, a lightning strike set a fire to a house, and this time it happened in Murray Hill.
And thankfully, no one was injured there, but that was just the beginning. In San Marco, take a look at what people were facing just a few hours ago.
Now, some homeowners forced to walk in knee-deep water just to get to their houses. First Coast News' Nick Perot is live tonight in San Marco. Nick?
Well, Heather, Anthony, good evening. Yes, when I was here a few hours ago, I was actually up to a little bit above my ankles and almost to my knees. But the good part is right now, most of that water has actually gone down, but there's still some left here in front of this homeowner's house here up against this fence line, a concern enough for him to say change still needs to come in here in San Marco.
Every time we have a lot of rain quickly, this happens.
Some may say this is just another day in Florida. It's to be expected. Care to take a seat at the new Whatley Memorial Swimming Pool? A few blocks away, good luck opening your door. For Andrew Ostrander, it was just a struggle getting to his front door.
When I got home from work, I had to park like a few blocks down that way to get into my house.
Cars like this one blocking Cedar Street, forcing police to come to the rescue.
Or I would say it's about 3 feet deep, and then the cars push through. They create a wake, and the water goes everywhere.
Kind of like that.
Just like that.
It just keeps coming, so still can't move. Just pretty much stuck here.
Danielle Curry got stuck driving through town on her way to her second job, leaving her in her car for 2 hours, waiting for the tow truck to arrive.
Just for an afternoon storm, and this isn't that bad, it's a little scary.
It's rained so much that the ground's really saturated and the water really doesn't have anywhere to go. The drainage doesn't work very well.
The Department of Public Works is planning an $8 million upgrade to area pumps, but it's still in the design phase and will take at least a year and a half to complete.
When you go into the alleyway, it dips down a little.
But following this rain, which came up to his knees, almost level to his fence line, water so high, his dog was forced to swim to find a place to go to the bathroom. Ostrander says homeowners need action now.
I think if there's a hurricane and it's this for a longer period of time, there could be some real
issues. Back out here live, just a reminder for you again, this is an $8 million project. It's going to take a year and a half or so to complete. Still in the design phase, this homeowner says, one of several I've talked to, says something has to be done. This has been a continuing process, as we know here in Florida, especially the San Marco area. Every time it rains, this is a problem they have to go through just to get to his front door, and others around here are concerned for them, calling for the city to make some changes. We're live tonight in San Marco. Nick Perot, First Coast News, on your side.